Hello friends, today we will get some idea about the mutual fund. Basically, mutual fund is a large pool of funds by many small investors, and then this pool of fund is managed by professional managers who invest this fund according to a predetermined goal, that is where this fund will be invested, whether in equity, in debt, or it will be a hybrid fund. Mutual fund is managed by asset management company called AMC. Mutual fund can be listed on the exchange called ETF or not listed on the exchange. Now, in case of mutual fund, you have to buy from the AMC, and when you are selling, you have to sell back to the AMC in case it is not listed. But if it is listed, you have to buy from some other investor who is holding these mutual fund units through stock exchange. Then mutual fund can be open-ended or closed-ended. In case of open-ended fund, you can invest anytime and you can redeem your units anytime. But in case of closed-ended fund, you can invest only when AMC, that is asset management company, launches a new fund. And the amount is redeemed to the unit holders when the period of this closed-ended fund expires. This period is decided and conveyed to investors in advance. Now, supposing in between somebody needs money, what he has to do? Most of the closed-ended funds are ETF, that is, they are traded on stock exchange. If I have invested in mutual fund today, in a closed-ended fund, I need money tomorrow, I will sell it on stock exchange. Most of the closed-ended funds are exchange traded. Then there are loads in mutual fund. Loads means mutual fund charges certain fees. These fees are essential because AMC manages its various expenses through loads. It is entry load, that is, at the time of investing in mutual fund charges certain amount. Exit load, when you are selling mutual fund back to AMC, that time AMC charges certain amount, which is exit load. Then mutual fund can be dividend fund or growth fund. In case of dividend fund, mutual fund declares part of its income as dividend to the fund holders. But in case of growth fund, mutual fund does not declare dividend. Instead, the amount which mutual fund has, it is invested back by the mutual fund, so the value of mutual fund keeps on increasing. Similar to growth fund is reinvestment fund. Based on investment avenue or aim of investments, mutual fund can be classified into equity fund, which invest only in equity, debt fund, these fund invest in fixed income papers, that is debt, and hybrid funds. Hybrid funds invest in debt as well as equity. Now, various types of debt fund. Various types of debt fund can be bond fund, who invest in corporate debt, bonds of companies, and G-Sec fund. These invest in Government of India securities. Various types of equity funds. These funds invest in equities of the company. They can be index fund, who invest only in index companies, that is BSE 30 or Nifty 50 stocks. Then large cap funds. Large cap funds invest only in companies which have very large caps, like top 50 or top 100 large cap companies. Then you have mid cap funds. These invest in mid cap companies. Then you have small cap funds. These invest in very small companies. Then we have dividend funds. Dividend yield funds means these funds invest in companies which pay very high dividend. Then we have diversified equity funds. Diversified equity funds invest in diversified companies depending on the will of fund managers. Then we have sectoral funds. Sectoral funds, they invest in a specific sector. For example, technology fund, it will invest only in technology companies. Pharma fund will invest only in pharma and healthcare companies. Financial fund will invest only in banks and non-banking finance company. Same way we have metal funds. same way we have commodities fund, same way we have FMCG funds, and so on and so forth. Now, what is NAV? That is very important aspect of mutual fund. NAV means net asset value. Supposing a fund comes up with a new offer. It issues units with denominator of rupees 10. If I apply for 1 lakh rupees, I will get 10,000 units. Somebody else applies with 10 lakh rupees, he will get 1 lakh unit because denominator of 1 unit is rupees 10. Supposing fund has 11 lakh total, they invest in an asset. Value of asset increases to 22 lakh, that is doubles. So the fund has actually issued how much? 1,10,000 units, and the value of assets have gone to 22 lakhs. Now the value of one unit will be 20 rupees because the value of asset has also gone up. This is called NAV. NAV is value of one unit of mutual fund. If a fund is doing very good, NAV increases, whereas if a fund doesn't do well, NAV decreases. When you are investing in mutual fund, you have to do very good homework. There are so many websites like Money Control, Mutual Fund India, Value Research, etc. Just search on the Google, you get at least 10-15 websites about mutual fund. Check out NAV of their top performing funds. They give the list of funds which have given best return in past 3 months, best return in 1 year, best return in 5 year, and since the beginning. And these funds are classified on the basis of bond fund, GSEC fund, index fund, equity sectoral funds, equity diversified funds, equity mid-cap fund, large-cap fund, and dividend yield fund. Mutual fund is very good way for investing for the beginners. Don't have much knowledge about the stock market, don't have much resources to invest about the companies. So you just check out who are the top performing mutual funds, top performing asset management companies, and invest in mutual fund where you feel that the asset management company and fund managers have been performing very good. I hope you got very good idea about the mutual fund, and this is very good way for the beginners to enter into stock market, to enter into GSEC, where you cannot buy government security because of very high denominator, but through mutual fund you can invest as low as 5,000 rupees in any mutual fund scheme and then keep on adding 500 rupees. Then there are ELSS also, equity linked saving scheme, where you invest in mutual fund, you also get tax benefit. I hope you all have got very good idea about the mutual fund, and this is a nice way to begin investing your funds for long-term capital appreciation through professional fund managers. Take care, all the best. In next video, I'll discuss more about various investment avenues.